Here we are at Southfield Reservoir near Thorn, and I've come out for a spot of bream fishing. With the World Feeder Championships now, it's all a different set of rules, and it's nice to come and practice them, i.e. 50 centimetre hook lengths. It's nice to get some distance fishing in again, but bream are feeding. I think I've had 16 bream at the moment, so it's a great way to come and have a little practice for old style bream fishing, if that's what you want to call it. We've got 50 centimetre hook lengths, open-ended feeder, and it's great to come out and have a little practice. And what I'll do, I'll show you what my setups, my rigs and everything like that, and show you what it's all about. It's a basic standard setup. SIPS rules say you've got to use an open or a block-ended feeder. There's no method feeders, anything like that, and the feeder's got to be free running. So I'm using an open feeder with a clip. So if I want to change the size of feeder, I can, which is quite important. It goes on to a quick change bead, one of the nicest little inventions ever made, and a 50 centimetre hook length. That's a minimum that we're allowed in SIPS rules. Now I know if I come on here I can use a shorter one, but I want to get used to using and fishing to SIPS rules, so I always fish with a 50 centimetre minimum hook length. That's 011 bottom and a size 18, a PR 355 hook. But the feeders is just a standard feeder. It's the biggest feeder today. The fish are feeding, so they're coming to the ground bait, which is nice. If it gets colder, I'll have a half size to that on. It's not putting as much bait in, but I want the fish to come to that bait. The ground bait is F1. I'm using F1 brown. If it gets, the water's quite coloured, so you can get away with that. If it's clear, I use F1 dark. And in that is standard baits. It's just a few maggots, pinkies and casters. And all I do in my ground bait, I like to mix the bait in my ground bait, just a few pinkies and a few casters, mix them in, and then I get the feeder and I press it in 1, 2, 3 one way, 1, 2, 3 the other, and just a gentle squeeze, not too tight, so I want the ground bait to come out. So that's the ground bait filled. The hook length, 50 centimetres, 2 dead maggots, I just get one out of the thing, I don't kill them before, and I just roll them in my fingers like that. Just kill them and put them on the hook. So two maggots. And that's a basic standard setup that I'll be using on all my rigs today. Now I know that I'm going to be casting 55 metres today, so I'm just using a SeaTech 11 foot. That rod will get me there comfortably. But it's not a rod that wants to go any further than that. So if I want to go further and further and further, I have to use a different technique and different set of rods, which I'll show you. So if I'm fishing 60 metres, that rod, the SeaTech 11, is perfect. But if I want to go further, 80 or 100 metres, you have to use a different technique, a different casting action and different tools for the job. So if I'm going 80 metres, I'm going to use a 12 foot 8 method feeder Dutch Master rod. That'll get me that distance perfectly. But if I want to go further than that, I've got to use a bigger tool, which is a 13 foot 8 100 gram Dutch Master rod. Them rods will get me that distance with the right reels. Now I'm going to catch another bream.